In this video, we're going to work on wrapping up this customization system. So we're going to be adding our hair color, our hat color, and we're going to try and add the randomize and reset button, as well as being able to save and load the specific outfits. So let's get right on into it. And we are going to start in the character data. So the first thing we're going to do is we need to add two things to our enum. So we need to add our hair and hat to the enum. And then we need to add a couple more export variables. So we're going to add an export variable for our hair color, which is going to be a color. And we're going to add another export variable for our hat color. And then we need to add export variables for our selected hair, which is going to be an integer to default to -1, should be equals. And then lastly, we're going to add one more for our selected hat, which is also going to default to -1. Let me fix some spelling here, and then let's add our default colors here. So the hair color, we're just going to do 0.35, 0.25, 0.15 by 1. And we're just going to do ones across the board for our hat color. Ah, right. Set these statically typed variables up properly, and now we should have no errors. Now we need to go back to our character scene to actually account for all this now. So we can duplicate the outfit twice, and we're going to call the first one hair, and the second one is going to be hat. We'll go into hair, go into our ordering, and we'll increase the Z index by 1. We'll do the same thing in hat, except we'll go up by 2. So that's all we need to do here. Now we can go back into our customization manager, and we need to go and add some additional variables. So we need our hair options, which is going to be another array of customization options. And we can default this to empty. I'm going to copy and paste this and fix my spelling errors. I cannot type. And this is going to be our hat options. And we need to go down to our update color, and we need to add two more matches here. So we're just going to copy and paste this to get the set. So then we need to also do this on the hair, and then we need to do this on our hat. And instead of it being skin color, we will get our hair color here. And then instead of skin color, when we match on the hat, we will get the hat color. Then we need to go up to update part, and we're going to do something similar. And so let's get our hair here, and we'll do hat, and then we can do the same thing here. So we're going to do our selected hair, and we're going to do our selected hat. Then we need to go down in to our load customization options. So we need to start making sure we're actually going to load up these options. So let me just do these quickly. So our outfit options are going to turn into our hair options. And then these ones that I copied will turn into our hat options. We're going to call the casual, like the first one, we're just going to have short hair. Then we'll have long hair. And then we're going to have cap. And we'll call the last one beanie. We need to also update all these file paths. You can drag and drop all these, but I'm just going to quickly type these in this way. Change it to base 2. This is going to be hat. And then base 2 for the hat. So these have to match the naming conventions that you have in your assets folder. Otherwise, they won't work. Doesn't matter what you call them, but you are going to need them to match in order for this to work properly. Then we're going to go down to our randomize character method, and we're going to do some stuff above here. So the first thing that we're going to do is get our character data, the skin color, want to have it equal color, and then I'm going to give it some random ranges. I'm going to copy and paste this in, but I'll explain what it is. We're going to give it right here. So what we're doing is we're passing in a random float in a range that we're giving it with the 1 of alpha. So it's just going to generate a random skin color within a realistic range. So it's not going to make a purple guy or an alien girl. Well, actually, yeah, if outfit options is empty, that's fine. So we're not going to return there. So we're going to do everything else below here. You can actually copy this. So we need to make sure that we do this for, so we're doing our outfit. We're going to have to do our hair color. So it's going to be selected hair. And then the last one is going to be for our hat color. So we're going to do our selected hat. Make sure instead of outfit options, we're doing hat options here. And then for the hair ones, we're doing our hair options. So you can tweak the ranges of these two. If you want to allow for crazier colors, you can do as you see fit here. But I think for just the purpose of getting this to the finish line quickly, this is going to be our best way to do this. Then we need to go back to our customization panel. And so we need to actually do something with these reset buttons. So what we're going to do, we're going to give the text of the reset button reset. And then we are going to have randomize. Let's give these some custom minimum sizes. We'll do 100 by 40, and we'll do that for both of them. Okay, and I think that's all we're going to need to do there, but we need to go back to our customization section. And let's start in our script. And what we're going to do is add two new constants, similar to how we have our outfit colors. We want to do this for our hair and skin colors also. So I'm going to copy and paste these in. You'll be able to pause and see what we're doing here. So we have the black, brown. We have a couple of these selected here. And then we have our skin colors here. Then we need to tweak some stuff in our setup. So in this if else block, we need to make some changes here. So I think we can get rid of this clear. We're going to do four options and option button. This can stay the same. This can stay the same. And then the last thing we're going to have to do is our option button dot item selected. We're going to connect to on option selected. Make sure those parentheses are removed and that you spell everything correctly, and that will be good. And then we need to tweak the setup color swatches. So the first thing that we're going to tweak here is that this is going to take in a colors, which is an array of color. And then we are going to set this up as a match. We make sure we don't have color type here. So we are going to also add another variable to our setup, and we're going to call this color type, which is a string, and it can default to an empty string. So then we're going to match on this new color type. And then if we get hair, we're going to set up color swatches. We're going to set up the color swatches, and we're going to give it the hair colors. If we match on skin, we're going to set up the color swatches for skin colors. And then if we get anything else, that's what that underscore does. We're going to set up color swatches on our outfit colors. This also does mean that we can simplify this a little bit. So we're no longer going to need, actually, sorry, we're going to keep everything as is, but we're just going to change the for loop. So we are going to loop over every color in colors. Now let's see if we need to make any updates to our create color style box. No, I think these should be fine. And on option selected is good. We need to update color, current color, new color. No, that's fine. And then what about update selection? No, our update selection is also good. So now we can go back to our customization panel, and we are going to do some script updates. In our create sections area, we're going to have to add two more of these add option selections. So the first one is going to be hairstyle, and the second one is going to be hat. And then we just have to start filling in all of these as well. We want to do our hair options here, and then our body part for the hat is going to be hat. It's not really a body part, but that's all right. And we're going to need to make, I believe, one more update. No, we are actually all good here. Okay, so let's save this and let's take a look. Update color swatches in base Vbox container does not have the same element. Okay, let's bring the debugger down. Okay, so this is saying we aren't getting an array of colors here. Saying that outfit colors is not an array of colors. Let's see if we just change this to an array. Okay, let's try this again. Okay. Now it's not working here, but we can still do the outfit. We can change the skin color. Randomize is working, but we're still not getting the hat colors, and we can also reset. And when we reset, it's not resetting to our base skin tone, but I think that's okay. So let's see what errors we got in the debugger. So we're getting item selected is already connected to the given callable. Okay, so let's go to the customization section. Can I go to this line, please? So in setup of our customization section, we're already saying we're already connected. Ah, we're already connected here. So this is a duplicate line. Don't know if that will completely solve our issues, but no, it does not. Okay, so our hair is not being selected still. Set the base, we can do our character data dot select base. I know we want to do our skin color and reset it to this. Okay, so we're going to do our skin color, set it equal to that. So that will at least handle. So when we randomize, now we go back to the starting, but we still are not able to add our outfits. Okay, so we need to also pop into this update character inside of the customization panel. So we're not actually doing anything when we're selecting it. We're only, right now, we're only changing the selected outfit. Okay, so let's see if we can do this right. So if the data dot, let's do, is it selected hat? We'll do selected hat is greater than zero. We'll do the, okay. So customization panel, we need to get, we have an outfit sprite right now in character. Okay, so we need to go bring up our character scene. We need our hair sprite and we need our hat sprite. So we weren't actually updating any of our sprites. So we will do the hat sprites texture. It's going to be the outfit options. We're going to do the, not the, not that. We are going to do the hat options at data.selectedHat. Data.dot will do hat color. Make sure that all of these are hat sprites. Okay, so let's see if this worked before we go and do the other one. So hat. Okay, so we got it to go, but we did not set the frames properly. So the where we're setting all of the V frames here. Yeah, we need, okay. So what we're gonna do, I'm gonna see if I can do this an easier way. So we're gonna do for sprite in, we'll do our outfit sprite, our hair sprite, and our hat sprite. We're just gonna do this. So on ready, we're just gonna loop through these and we'll do sprite for each of these just so we can set all of these up. So now we go and play this. Character, cannot parse global class character. Okay, I must have done, I need the colon here, okay. So, hat, boom, beanie, nice. Hair still won't work. Now we have this customization. So now, let's go back down here. We'll do this. I could also for loop this most likely, but I think for right now, we're just gonna do it this way. Selected hair, and then we'd make this our hair sprite. And then this is going to be our hair options and the data at selected hair and the data dot hair color. Okay, let's play it. We can randomize and now everything actually works and we can go back and remove stuff. We can reset. The hat didn't get reset, so that's good, but everything else does work. Okay, so let's go back. So when we're going and we're resetting our character, we are not resetting everything here. So we need to mirror this. So we want to do selected hat. We have selected outfit, and then we want to do selected, not hat again, we want to do hair. Okay, now when we do this, randomize, reset. Okay, awesome. So now that that's done, the last thing that we need to do is try and implement the save and load functionality of this.